Meet dude. He is living a happy life in Iceland. But it can get a little cold down there. So he decides to buy a proper house and start a family. He takes a huge loan for this new house and is a little concerned who will pay off the loan in case something happens to him. To cover the risk, he buys a term insurance which will pay off in case something happens to him. Dude, being the mature family man, is doing all he can in order to protect his family. Now you must be wondering, how is this related to SQL and database? Well, this entire course will explain SQL concepts as they are used in a real insurance company. A lot of courses out there explain what and how of SQL and database. With this course, we will also learn why along with what and how. Now, insurance goes back as old as 1300s. Back then, the houses were made of wood, and if one of the houses was burned, the neighbors will pool money to rebuild it. Modern insurance is no different. Now also, people pool money by paying premiums, and they are covered against a financial loss in case of any unfortunate circumstance. But with rising population, globalization, and evolution of technology, things have become a lot more complicated. Let's rewind 40 years back when all the things were maintained on physical books. You bought a health insurance which will cover up to 100k in medical expenses if something happens to you. You were hospitalized and you took a claim of 10k. So your coverage amount has reduced to 90k now. Now the person managing the physical books has two options. Either he can cut 100k and write 90k close to it, or he can insert a new entry with a recent date with the updated coverage amount. In database concepts, if he decides to strike off the entry and write the updated amount in place of it, this is called SCD1 or slowly changing dimension 1, where we do not maintain history. And if he decides to insert a new entry while keeping the previous one, this is called SCD2, where we maintain history. This is how this entire course is designed. If you are creating a table, inserting some data, you will know why that is being done. If an index is created or a table is partitioned, you will be told why that is required in a real project. Although this course is suitable for all people who are trying to learn SQL, it is more suitable for people who are at new to intermediate level in SQL and databases. People with prior experience may find it a little elaborative at times, but it will definitely refresh some of their concepts as well. We are going to talk about a lot of important business concepts like digital marketing, sales, upselling, cross-selling, productivity, underwriting, reinsurance, and how SQL and databases help in them. I'm very excited about this course. I hope so are you. So let's get started.